I wanted to share a couple of simple mistakes, simple observations that I see in some paintings. And I'm going to paint a simple lemon form here based upon a light source that you can see off to the left. So I'm going to assume that this is going to be a lemon. And my light source is coming in. If it's a warm light in a warm environment, I'm going to have warm highlights, and I'm going to have a warm cast shadow down in here. So depending upon your light source, direction of it, and the size of it, could determine how large the cast shadow you have. The brighter this is, the stronger the edge is going to be between the light shape and the shadow shape. Also, be much darker over here. So let's assume we have warm light coming in here. This is a lemon that you're trying to create. People will, this is just the way that I do it. Notice I like to start off here on a very white surface when I'm trying to paint these lemons, and something that I call the lemon theory, which basically means that the purer the white that's underneath it, the brighter the your yellow, or in this case, your lemon color is going to turn out to be. Great. So if my light source is coming in here, if it's warm, this side, I can just lighten it up. If I have this intense or there's a simple modeling that starts to take place in here. Move it around. And the core shadow that kind of moves back up through here. Already created a nice gray. I'll put behind my painting. So in modeling something that simple, quite often what I do, in order to get what everybody's so curious about, is this nice, loose, beautiful edges and all this. Constructed and deconstructed edges that I get. I'm using just a basic palette knife. care about whether or not, in this case, this nice white line all across here, because that to me is nothing more than an opportunity, a visual opportunity to play with here. Really about how much fun I can have in any given shape, whether it's the shadows, highlights, other colors I may introduce into the painting. Choose to clean up the edges. You can just keep going on and on and on with this. Make it as abstract as an idea as you want. That you'd like to clean back up. Others, if you don't like it, you can just remove it. So you can see that any one object, anything that you're painting, any one element can just be endless as far as its possibilities, its visual possibilities. So this is just one element that's within this particular painting that I can just continue to move. So when you guys are asking me about how I do these deconstructed paintings, it's just this, it's tearing it down. Why not use some sandpaper, right? Look at the beautiful lines that are created here. So one element can just continue to go and to grow. Until you, as the artist, choose to leave it alone. My point being, don't be afraid to play with your paintings, an object or something as simple as that. In this case, this lemon. Let's just get really aggressive with it. You see, you just take and can play with an idea absolutely forever. One simple object here. You just keep exploring and pushing. Until it gets to where you really find the beauty in it. Really enjoying that now. There you go. That's kind of how I do all of my paintings throughout, except they could take weeks if months to not create this kind of a nice, beautiful look throughout a piece. I'll photograph this and send it, put it on my Facebook page here. If you'd like to know more about this matrix, warm light, cool light, cool light, cool light, warm and cool shadows and things of that nature. You can go to my website at spoonerfineart.com and go to my sign it page there, and periodically I'll send out little hints and things like that about painting, little videos and stuff like this. So anyway, sorry I didn't take any of your questions. I was really trying to focus on this, and thanks a lot.